It's quite a taboo subject, I think. Some people don't really necessarily know how they should approach the question or what they should say. As a club and as athletes, we can just push the conversation more.
In general, I think it's quite a vigorous training week. Significant, like, intensity on the body, I think. So, like, the normal person might go to the gym, for example, but I think probably what we do is a lot harder work than that.
When you're younger, kind of, you don't look to your nutrition as much, but obviously now when you're in a professional environment, you're looking for like the 1% and the small gains. Obviously a good balanced diet, having the right supplements, having the right vitamins, hugely important for match days, for training weeks. Now as a professional, I'm more aware of how important food and nutrition is for fuel.
I think it's really important. We're lucky enough that we have lunch here, so we'll have breakfast at home, we'll then have lunch here, which fuels us then for our training session in the afternoon. I think it's really important that you're eating the right things and enough of the right things to optimise your performance.
Yes, I think, you know, being a woman, it's important to know your own body and your feelings when you're on your period and when you're coming on and things like that.
It affects you massively, obviously physically. You feel kind of low when you come into training, like probably more muscle aches, you've got back pains, like the normal kind of symptoms you have. And obviously like emotionally as well, you could be quite up and down. And I think it's just here at Palace, we do a lot of work with like tracking where we are. So there's four phases, phase 1, 2, 3 and 4. The staff are aware of like where we're at, but I think it's important for us as professional athletes and as women at the end of the day to see where we are so we can manage and control with nutrition, with supplements, and also just know where we are like emotionally. Like maybe one day after training you're a bit tired, and that's fine because, for example, you're on phase 2 or 3. So it's really important to know that. It's massive. So there's physical effects and obviously mental effects as well.
I know that nutrition and what you eat is really important in the different phases. I mean, there's different nutrients and foods that are better for each one. So yeah, we probably have to take a bit more notice in terms of what we're putting in our body at different times of the month.
Nutrition is hugely important for females, obviously in your menstrual cycle as well. I know that ginger, you're meant to have a lot of ginger on your period on like phase 4. So yeah, it's hugely important. And I think the shots can really help with that.
It's so important to fuel your body the correct way and get all the nutrients and everything you need. I think that's why the turmeric is so important, because it really helps with detoxifying and helps with recovery as well, whilst giving you an energy boost. So getting the right food on board and adding the shots to my diet has been so helpful.
In terms of sort of immunity and fighting off like bugs and sickness and stuff like that, it's good for that side of things. Obviously you don't really want to be missing any training due to sickness or illness, so I think it's good that it helps the immune system as well as sort of aiding, you know, the physical recovery side of things.
They're always in for us when we come into training, so I have them in the mornings before training. I like the immune support shot, so that's always nice to have in the morning. It's the vitamin C and D3 one. I mean, it feels like it just gets my day going.